Thank you. together. Almighty God, your sovereign purpose brings salvation to earth. Give us faith to be steadfast amid the tumults of this world, trusting that your kingdom comes and your will is done. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
You may be seated for special news. Located after page 338 and before the hymns. We will be reading by half verse, meaning you all will read the indented portion. Psalm 16. Protect me, O God, for I take refuge in you.
I have said to the Lord, you are my Lord, my good above all other.
All my delight is in the godly that are in the land.
Upon those who are noble among the people.
But those who run after other gods
shall have their troubles multiplied.
I will not pour out drink offerings to such gods.
Never take their names upon my lips.
O Lord, you are my portion and my cup.
It is you who uphold my lot.
My boundaries enclose the pleasant land.
Indeed, I have a rich inheritance.
I will bless the Lord who gives me counsel.
My heart teaches me night after night.
I have set the Lord always before me.
Because God is at my right hand, I shall not be shaken.
My heart, therefore, is glad, and my spirit rejoices.
My body also shall rest in hope.
For you will not abandon me to the grave.
Nor let your Holy One see the pit.
You will show me the path of life.
In your presence there is fullness of joy, and in your right hand are our pleasures forevermore.
Our second reading this morning comes from Hebrews, the 10th chapter. And every priest stands day after day at his service, offering again and again the same sacrifices that can never take away sins. But when Christ had offered for all time a single sacrifice for sins, he sat down at the right hand of God, and since then has been waiting until his enemies would be made a footstool for his feet. For by a single offering he has perfected for all time those who are sanctified. Therefore, my friends, since we have confidence to enter the sanctuary by the blood of Jesus, by the new and living way that he opened for us through the curtain, that is, through his flesh, and since we have a great priest over the house of God, let us approach with a true heart in full assurance of faith, with our hearts sprinkled clean from an evil conscience and our bodies washed with pure water. Let us hold fast to the confession of our hope without wavering, for he who has promised is faithful. And let us consider how to provoke one another to love and good deeds, not neglecting to meet together, as is the habit of some, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day approaching. Would you please stand for the reading of the gospel? Our gospel reading this morning comes from Mark, the 13th chapter. As Jesus came out of the temple, one of his disciples said to him, "Look, teacher, what large stones and what large buildings." Then Jesus asked him, "Do you see these great buildings? Not one stone will be left here upon another. All will be thrown down." When he was sitting on the Mount of Olives opposite the temple, Peter, James, John, and Andrew asked him privately, "Tell us, when will this be? And what will be the sign that all these things are about to be accomplished?" Then Jesus began to say to them, "Beware that no one leads you astray. Many will come in my name and say, 'I am he,' and they will lead many astray. When you hear of wars and rumors of wars, do not be alarmed. This must take place, but the end is still to come. For nations will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. There will be earthquakes in various places. There will be famines. This is but the beginning of the birth pangs." This is the gospel of our Lord. You may be seated, and I will invite the kids to come forward for a children's message. repeat after me, okay? Dear God.
Dear God.
Thank you. For reminding us that we are never alone.
Help us to
always feel your love in all we do. In your name we pray.
To give us people to lean on, to rest.
was the time that I spent on the palliative care team, as their focus was on providing comfort. Walking with patients and families during severe illnesses and injuries, and helping to make their life most comfortable and purposeful. This sometimes meant preparing a patient and their family for hospice once they left the hospital, and sometimes it meant not leaving the hospital at all. So one afternoon, I had been on the phone all morning arranging rides and discharges and getting people out the door so that we could fill the beds. I was brought in on a case. I was notified of a patient on my floor who was moved to end-of-life care and for whom we were not planning a discharge, meaning that she would not survive the process of leaving the hospital. Her family wasn't there yet. They were en route, and the nurse practitioner wasn't sure if she would make it until they arrived. I walked to her room, and I saw that she was alone. So I decided to sit with her. I knew that if this was my grandmother or family member, I would not want them to be alone. I silenced my phone and sat with her until someone else came to relieve me. This moment was incredibly clarifying for me and helped me to see the bigger picture of who we are called to be as neighbors to one another. We are called to love one another, to support each other, and to share the love of God with one another, just as God remains with us and is faithful to us at every point in our lives. So although she was sleeping and in a fairly unconscious state, I do feel that she knew someone was there, that God was with her as I sat with her, to provide comfort and make sure she felt cared for and loved in her final moments. About 45 minutes later, a palliative care nurse came in and took my place to sit with her until the family arrived. She passed the next day when her family could be there to surround her with love and comfort, just as God had been doing all along. The hope that Jesus attests to in this passage is not a denial of the struggles, the pain, or sometimes the agony of human life, or the struggles that his disciples will surely face once he's gone. These are all very real emotions and very real concerns to his followers. Jesus says, "Beware that no one leads you astray. Many will come in my name and say, 'I am he,' and they will lead many astray." Jesus is reminding the disciples the importance to remember God's promises in the midst of persecution, in the midst of hardship, in the midst of challenges, to remember the love of God when they face adversity, to remember that eternal life is in the coming kingdom. This is God's promises in Jesus Christ. In this text, we understand that our lives will not always be easy. It is not easy to be a follower of Jesus, nor are many things we face in life. We will all struggle, and Jesus does not hide this idea from us. Instead, Jesus tells us the truth that will set us free to be who God has called us to be and to share God's love with our neighbor. To live with the gift of faith empowering us to go into the world and share the good news of God's grace, God's mercy, and God's forgiveness. As we face the painful and challenging parts of life, God sees us for who we truly are. The parts of us that are in pain, parts of us that struggle, parts of us with joy. And God is there with us and sends others to be with us. I'm sure all of us have had those coincidences, or so we call them, of the right person showing up at the right time, or the piece of comfort that we most needed to hear or feel happens to us when we need it most. Coincidence? Think not. That is God at work in our lives through the Holy Spirit, permeating all of who we are to help us through our pain and suffering and bring us into new life with Christ in and among us. Dear friends in Christ, I encourage you to notice where God shows up in your life, especially in those around you. I saw this quote the other day that I think speaks to this very idea. you are able for our hymn of the day, O Jesus, I Have Promised, number 810 in the red. Lord, in your others to be advocates for justice where there is oppression, peace where there is tension, wholeness where things are broken. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Compassionate God, we know that we have salvation and eternal life in you through the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. Empower us to live boldly in our faith with hope ahead of us and our experience behind us that makes us stronger. We ask you to help us live in the present and appreciate the blessings in life. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Into your hands we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy.